So we have later on this talk to some.
Cool. Okay.
I don't know if you need that or not. Yeah. Let's cheat on the system.
Sure.
Okay.
Boxes will make a big difference. You can place the digital box next to your computer or streamer or whatever, and then connect it up with plastic between the two boxes, so you're not going to get any ground loops, noise, jitter, any that kind of stuff. In the analog box, there's three layers of.
So I'm trying to figure out, okay, a DAC is digital to analog. So what's in the digital side and what's in the analog side? Because at one point, there's the chip, right, that does
there's
the magic.
There's no chip here. There's no chip.
It's the FPGA.
So, no, that's not it either. The analog box is basically what most people put in a chip.
Okay.
The analog box is a glorified filter for the 11 megahertz DSD signal. It's a low-pass filter, and that's its whole purpose in life.
Oh, okay.
And so the digital box is just like the digital card in the DS. It takes in any digital inputs, upsamples them, blah, 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 and you end up with the 11 megahertz DSD signal.
Okay.
And then that 11 megahertz signal goes over this and gets reclocked in the analog box. So I was exaggerating a little bit with the analog box being a low-pass filter. It's got the clock in it, which is the right place to have the clock.
Okay.
It's got the digital reclockers. There's three of them in series in there.
Oh, wow.
And it's got excellent power supplies.
Yeah.
We're trying to be good citizens on the power supplies and just take the current on the sides rather than the tops so that we take it when other people aren't injecting crap and we don't put crap into their other people's systems
on
the top. And so, I don't know if you know about power.
Go ahead. Yeah.
If you don't know, we're going to get it like a 0.96 power factor.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And, you know, that's showing that we're getting the current other than just at the tip, right?
Right, right.
And I think that'll be also important in how the whole thing sounds.
Yeah, okay. And I noticed you're going with a newer generation FPGA chip.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This thing's actually a little wrong.
Okay.
The newer chip, you know, for about the same money, you get about 2.5 times the performance.
Oh, wow.
But running the DS software in here is using up about a quarter of the resources, which is also nice. So I'll have a lot more room, both for experimentation and, you know, I can put more snowmassness in here with the more resources, right? So, and the same thing, there's some Huron and Red Cloud features that by using more resources, I'll be able to get you more of those deltas you've seen there.
Oh, really? Okay.
And so I'm enjoying writing that kind of that part of the software too.
Yeah.
Although right now the most important thing is getting the hardware done so that we can get the boards turned so that we can get the.
Okay.
And then I'll be working on the software.
Yeah.
A lot.
What else do we need to know about the unit?
All of the inputs and outputs will have user selectable ground lifts.
Okay.
So that we can lessen the ground loop noises you have in some systems, and also, as you know, some. Interconnects and stuff sound better if they're grounded on the source and others if they're grounded on the destination.
Right.
So you'll be able to pick which kind of grounding schemes you have on all inputs and all outputs on this.
Okay.
And similarly, the analog outputs will have a few more options for balanced versus symmetrical. In other words, is the middle grounded?
Yeah.
And you can have a balanced RCA connection as well if your amp supports it.
Yeah.
Or if it doesn't, you can float the bottom ground so it's balanced.
Yeah. Okay.
And another minor thing, but it'll matter to a lot of people, is that instead of just a 20 dB attenuator, there's a 10, 20, or 30 dB attenuator. Mm-hmm. Once again, to help better match people's systems.
Mm-hmm. Kind of give them a little more options.
Yeah, I mean, some people have extremely sensitive speakers.
Yeah.
And so you'll need more attenuation for those. And I don't know what the number would be, but there's some customers that 20 dB attenuation is just too much.
Yeah.
Right. When they use that, they can't quite get the loudness they want for listening and stuff.
Right.
So the 10 is kind of a sweet spot for that.
Okay.
And then having the RCA being able to be balanced gives you 6 additional dB.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
For, you know, those systems.
Right. Right.
So that's sort of one of the things we want to do, is just make it integrate in people's systems better. Integrate better on the power supplies, integrate better on the grounding, integrate better to their preamps if they have it or their amps if they don't.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's where a lot of the resources are going.
Okay.
If you look at the inside, this looks a lot like the digital card in the DS, but you know, it's got the isolation with the ground lifts and stuff around the edges and stuff like that. Yeah. So it's bigger and has more stuff, and it's got more than half of the board is power supplies.
Right.
And the same thing on the analog box.
Okay.
So, you know, it's a bigger board like this because it's got to have a lot of room for all the power supplies, and it's got to have, instead of just the mute relay, it's got seven relays for the different options.
Okay.
But the analog signal doesn't go through all of those, right? The for example, the attenuators are shunts to ground, so that you're not dirtying the signal as it goes out.
Yeah.
And the only thing that the mute relay, of course, shorts the analog signal, so you don't care about it going through there.
Wow, that's really, really exciting stuff.
I've been, you know, I've been working on, thinking about it for a while, and you know, getting, making it reliable connection from the top to the bottom. You know, that's that takes work, and that's the main reason actually we're doing a board turn, is just to make that better.
So, so I mean, if you were to give a ballpark percentage, how far do you think this is along?
How far in
from
it, completion?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I've been saying that we'll be lucky if we get it out by the end of the year. It'll, you know, it'll be at least 2 weeks for, I mean, 2 months for another board turn. There's still work here, a lot of software, and then going into production and beta, all, that all takes time. That,
yeah, no, definitely.
So I don't know what PS Audio says on that. They may have a bit more accurate or less accurate answer than that.
I just need to know if I need to start saving my Christmas money right now.
I don't know if Bill says it. Thinks I should have said something different or not, but
I mean, we're really excited for you, and we had, I follow you guys on the forums, and I know you guys have talked about this sort of no compromise.
Yeah, I hate that phrase. Yeah, because there's always a budget.
Yes, of course. But
and you don't want to spend the customer's money needlessly.
Right.
And PS Audio has a certain value proposition. We looked at getting milled aluminum cases for it, but you know, that would have more than doubled the price of the whole thing.
Yeah.
Just right there, that single item, and it's like, no, I can take that money and get you a lot better sound. Rather than, you know, making it look pretty.
Yeah, I've seen some of those units that have that.
They look nice. I wanted to do it, but then you know, they would be great. Were very accommodating and checking it out for me, even if they didn't think it was going to fly.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I guess you did your due diligence, at least you could.
Yeah. No, and you know, one fellow there had enough experience that he made a seat of the pants guess, and then they went out and got an official quote, and it's almost identical.
Yeah.
But you know, I appreciate taking the time to do that.
Yeah, very cool.
You know, and I like the way the boxes are coming out. I just saw it for the first time today.
It's gorgeous, actually.
Yeah, and I've seen some of the prototype displays. They're beautiful.
I was gonna say, is this whole thing part of the display, or?
I may get burned on this. There's sections that'll be very high quality display.
Okay.
And then other sections that might be more like indicator lights and stuff like that.
Okay.
But what I really wanted, you know, the junior with the knob.
Yeah.
I love that knob, right?
Yeah.
Something's too loud, you just grab it. So we want to have it so you can just reach over and turn it down or up with a swipe.
Yeah.
So we want enough of the display to be active, that you don't have to sit there with a microscope to figure out how to go up or down a dB, right?
I'm not so accurate with my reaches sometimes.
Well, honestly, because they can be separated, I'm going to put the digital box right next to my listening position, and then I can drive the display just fine that way, and then the analog box will be up next to the rest of the system. But I know that, you know, a lot of people are more comfortable with remote controls and stuff like that, and so they're trying to get a nice remote with a really smooth knob on that to run the volume control. Excuse me. And other options. So I'm looking forward to that. I haven't seen their prototypes on that yet.
Okay.
Because I'm up in Washington, they're down in Boulder. So any other kinds of questions there?
No, thank you for walking us through it. I was really excited to kind of hear what you have to say about it, and kind of getting that explanation of the analog and digital. That was
You know, if you're going to have two boxes, it seems like the best split to me.
Yeah.
You know, Paul initially was wanting a power supply versus the rest, but you know, when the power goes out, the umbilical comes in, it's degraded somewhat, and this separating the digital from the analog is a huge difference in quality, right?
Okay.
Compared to, I mean, the digital's where all the noise is. It's going to be next to the noisy part of your system, plugged into where your noisy part of your system is, and the analog can be right up next to your preamp or amps.
Yeah.
You know, and be a good citizen, not you know, wash and noise.
Yeah.
And there's, you know, there's no processors in the analog box. There's no, you know, any digital crap like that at all. I mean, if you consider a reclocker digital, yes, there's a digital in there, but you know, it's ECL. It's something that it's sort of like class A digital.
Right, right.
If you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.